Hello everyone, welcome to another open box video. Today we're looking at the Echo chainsaw model number CS-310, and I picked this up from Home Depot. So what I'm going to do is open the box and explain what's inside, as well as giving this a test run. So if you're interested in getting a chainsaw, then you'll know what to expect. Alright, first thing first, my favorite. You have the manual. Some warranty on it. I went ahead and bought me an extended warranty, so you got some paper on that. Okay, so what else do we have here? We also have some type of tool to be used, and so we'll play with that. And also, it does come with oil. Alright, so let's pull this out of the box. Nice weight to it, very nice. Okay, so let's talk about some of the features that we have on this chainsaw. This is the rear handle for your right hand. This is gonna be your throttle trigger. This is gonna be your ignition switch. This is gonna be your fuel tank cap, this is where your fuel goes. This is gonna be your cylinder cover latch. This is gonna be your starter handle. This is gonna be your front handle for your left hand. And right behind the handle, it's going to be your oil tank cap. This is where you're going to place your oil. Okay, so now let's remove the chain guard here. Okay, this little bubble thing is going to be your purge pump. And right back here is going to be your choke control knob. And this is going to be your chain brake lever. And this sharp thing is going to be your saw chain. This is your guide bar. This part is your chain catcher. This is going to be your chain tension adjuster. This piece right here is your chain brake sprocket guard. And this is going to be your muffler, which is going to be really hot, so make sure your hand does not touch that. And that is it. Okay, did you get all that? Let's go on to the next step. Okay, everyone, so this is going to be the most crucial part of setting up your new Echo. Right now, we're going to put fuel into the machine, and we're also going to put oil. So we want to make sure we never ever put straight gasoline into this unit, because if we do, we're just going to ruin it. So when you buy your CS-310, it's going to come with this Echo mixture right here. This is what's going to go into your gasoline. The best thing to do is to go to your local hardware, pick yourself up a 1 gallon fuel can, and use that as a reference. Also, I recommend that when you put oil, get the Echo oil. I got this at Home Depot. So in the Home Depot section where the chainsaws are at, they do sell oil. Make sure that you get the same brand. It's always recommended to get the same brand. I want to also mention to you that in stores, they do sell 50-to-1 pre-mixed fuel already. You can buy this. I personally will not be using this at all, because I did some research and I found that in some units, not all, but in some units, the RPMs go really low and it doesn't have a lot of power. It could be maybe because it's a bad mixture, I don't know. If you're going to use any type of fuel for the Echo unit, stick with Echo brand stuff, like this 1 gallon mix that they provide for you when you purchase your item, and go from there. Echo pretty much recommends using their products for their units, and that's what I'm going to do. Alright, so real quick before I get this thing started, I want you to make sure that the chain is tense pretty good. You don't want it very loose. If it's very loose, it could become very dangerous, so just make sure it has good tension before starting. Alright, so before we start the chainsaw, please be sure and be safe to wear some mask, whatever type of shield you have. This is not the appropriate shield for my face, but it is something. So I want to go ahead and make sure I got that on. Make sure you wear a long sleeve shirt, pants, and also gloves if you have those as well. So the first thing you're going to want to do is make sure that this chain lock is pushed forward, because you want to make sure that the chain is not spinning when you start the unit. And also too, you want to make sure that the ignition switch is on, pull the choke back, leave the choke on, and then I'm going to start it. Now when I start it, it's not going to start right away. Once I do that first pull, what's going to happen, I'm going to shut the choke off, so that way it doesn't flood itself. To start this thing, you're going to need to put your foot right in it. So best thing to do is take your foot, hold it down just like that. Take your hand and start.
want to push this back. So with your stick, when you're ready to cut, you want to take your left leg, point it over, hold the chainsaw on this side, but never in front of you. Alright, so that's basically how you do it. I'm going to stop right here, give in a demonstration, and just to let you know, I pretty much like this thing. This is very powerful, more powerful than I expect it to be. Yep, this is definitely a good brand. As you can see, they did a really good job cutting up the wood. So in my next video, I'm going to show you how to maintain this product so that way you can use it for many, many years. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And I'll see you on my next video.